What I'd like to say is that obviously today has been a very busy day. It has been full of inspiring talks, motivational speeches, lots of networking, and very useful workshops. And I hope that it's all been very useful to you. I mean, it's very useful for me. I mean, for the first time, I've actually heard the word re-mosque, you know, somebody who is unmosqued. And this was the sister from America, Sister Juhi, who was mentioning, and she played a clip from Sheikh Omar Suleiman, and he's actually talking about people who are unmosqued and how we have to re-mosque them. And I've never heard that the word used in that way. So that definitely there has been a lot of use today, and I'm sure you have benefited a lot. We began today by talking about the prophetic mosque, the model of the prophetic mosque. And I'm sure that this theme has come out through the talks today. One thing which I'm not sure that has come out about the prophetic mosque is that when we actually think about the prophetic mosque, that mosque had no dome. It had no minaret. It had no mihrab. It had no carpet. It even didn't have any doors. You know, it had obviously the entrance, but it didn't even have doors. Yet this mosque revolutionized the whole world. It brought so much to the world because the focus of the mosque wasn't on the exterior and the construction, but the focus was on the substance, was focused on the people, was focused on those who carried their message. And I think one of the things that, in fact, the Prophet told us, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is that one of the things of the times to come is that people just become concerned with the etching of the mosques and the decoration of the mosques. And so you have these fascinating mosques to look at, but there is no substance. So I hope one thing that we take away from today is that that is as much importance in the prophetic masjid model. Brother Hassan started off by mentioning that actually this conference isn't being held in a mosque, but it is being held in the Quaker Center. And one thing that stood out for me as I was looking at some of the messages here in Friends House is the notion of putting our faith into action and also about promoting our faith and work. And I think this is also important. This is very central for the organizations like MCB and indeed the mosques, where we are trying to say that actually faith plays a role in society. And the more Muslims are practicing the faith, the more they can give society, and not the other way around. Not that we need less faith, we actually need more faith, and we need more inspiration that comes with faith. And today has never been just about today. Things don't finish here. In fact, things start now, and that's why it's important for us to go away, hopefully being inspired and motivated by the speeches, the wonderful speeches that we had, the workshops, that what can we do? How can we change our mosques to become those vehicles for change and those vehicles for positivity in society today? So indeed, we have some initiatives, as you have already heard about. So there is the Better Mosques, a community consultation, which will be starting to run from today until the end of March. It's a consultation which is about understanding and thinking about the services, the structure that we have, and how we can benefit mosques in the future. So again, we do urge you to look at that and to find out more and to be part of that consultation. Also, you heard about the 5 working groups that the MCB is launching today as well. So again, this is important for us. I think everyone should try and get involved in at least one of those. And again, more information is on our website, Our Mosques, Our Future. Something more close and in the horizon, which is Visit My Mosque. Is there something up there? Visit My Mosque, which is on the 18th of February. That's it's about 4 weeks from now. If your mosque hasn't registered, please make sure it does register and that you don't miss out. So please register, get involved. It's a great national event to be a part of. So lots of things happening and lots of things that we can do, and so many things that we can do more of. And I think, inshallah, we can hopefully go away having changed ourselves, our outlook, and inshallah, the people around us.